with the whispers of truth. To live a conscious life, to live a conscious life. On the growing edge, on the growing edge. Hi, I'm Ali Benjamin with Growing Edge Live Sunday broadcast. We come to you live every Sunday to share spiritual food for thought and nourishment, a little spiritual tune in and tune up. So let's begin with a little centering. If you will, close the outer eyes and tune in and take a few deep cleansing breaths and allow yourself to settle and center and enter into this sacred container for growth and evolution and healing and calming, and to activate that inner sparkle, that light, that wisdom, activating intuition and deepening into our soul. Another deep breath and open the eyes. So welcome. No is a complete sentence. That's the title of my talk today. And I have struggled with this my entire life. I have been known to be a yeser, someone that says yes when I mean no, and it's a little embarrassing, but you can probably relate. Do you have trouble saying no to people? Do you say yes too often to things that you're not in alignment with? Because when we say yes to things that we're really not in alignment with, we can feel overwhelmed, stressed. We can get really upset with ourselves, and then resentment can move in, and we can feel burned out. You probably know what I'm talking about. So I have some questions that I pose to you so that you might take a deeper look at this bad habit of saying yes when you mean no. So are you honoring the time that you need for your personal growth, for your sense of peace and well-being? Are you honoring that? Do you take time for yourself, or are you busy taking time for others? Are you putting yourself lower on your list and putting others' needs, wants, and desires above your own? So that's one thing you might want to think about. Another is, do other people treat you like a doormat? Because if we get into the habit of saying yes too often, then people can take that for granted, especially those in our lives that put their own needs ahead of yours. In an ideal world, we would all honor and respect each other and really want for each other the very best. And that really means honoring our loved ones' personal goals and dreams and desires, and knowing that their personal dreams and desires probably come before ours. And so it's honoring each other in a way that is so beautiful. And really saying no can be a spiritual practice. It can allow others to pick up the reins and take responsibility for their own lives. And maybe they've got into a habit of asking you to do things for them that they really need to start doing for themselves. Why do you feel that you always get upset when people seem to take you for granted? And this can really cause us to feel resentful when we feel like we're being taken for granted, but we're saying yes anyway, and we keep doing it. What do they say? Doing the same thing over and over, over and over again and expecting a different result. That's the definition of insanity. Well, feeling taken for granted is kind of like that. If we keep on allowing ourselves to feel that way, it's a good indication that we're saying yes when we mean no. So the last question is there a good reason for you to be a yes person? Sometimes saying yes, of course, being helpful, being kind, being cooperative, working as a team, working on a particular project together where we have to compromise a little bit. That's not what I'm talking about. Saying yes when it's appropriate is equally as powerful. But saying no, can be life-changing. No can actually be a whole sentence. But many of us have also got into the habit of defending our no, of coming up with all kinds of reasons why we have to say no. And that is a slippery slope. When we can simply relax, when we have the awareness that no can be a complete sentence. Try it right now. Just say it. No. You can say it in a relaxed way that doesn't have to build up anxiety and stress inside you. Just say it. No. See, the world didn't end. Nothing crazy happened. We can say no and it's going to be okay. What's the worst thing that can happen by saying no to someone that's used to us saying yes? Maybe momentarily they'll be surprised, or maybe they'll stop asking you to do things that they can do for themselves. And sometimes we lose friends when we start saying no. Those that have become particularly accustomed to us saying yes can get really offended. But we have to ask ourselves, is that relationship worth it if it's based on me always saying yes and never saying no? So we're all wired to come up with reasons to explain to people why we can't say yes, why we can't say no, and why we have got into the habit of saying yes. So when we do that, we can feel it. You go, it's as though, I know when I do it, when I start justifying, making excuses, giving reasons and meaning to why I say no, I begin to feel less empowered. I begin to feel less myself. I begin to feel awkward. And so you probably have felt that yourself. When we say yes when it's appropriate and no when it's appropriate, we begin to feel freer and happier. And you'll find yourself doing things that you really enjoy versus doing things that you don't want to do, that bring you a sense of that you're just doing it out of obligation. This is really self-care. When we begin to really spiritually wake up, take care of ourselves, and to learn to say yes when it's appropriate, no when it's appropriate, we begin to have less negative anxiety around saying no, and we begin to own our yes and own our no. So let's practice saying no together today. So first of all, the most important thing is not to defend your no. Or you're going to get, if you do this, you're going to get into this energy of not owning your no, of not feeling worthy of owning it. You are an absolutely valuable, worthy person of having the life that you want to have. And if saying no means that you have to risk or be vulnerable, I challenge you to do it anyway, because that energy of I'm not worthy is not somewhere that you want to hang out. You can practice saying no with more confidence. No, no, thank you. Sorry, no, I'm not able to do that. Try it. I'm sorry, no, I'm not able to do that. You can do it. It's easy. And it gets easier the more you do it. So you just start simply. You start with friends that you already have a fairly easy yes and no with. And you just practice saying it. No, sorry, I'm not going to do that. Sorry, that's not for me today. And maybe it will be it tomorrow. And you can also say no with more love in it. That's a concept, to say no with love. Now, you don't have to say, I'm saying no with a lot of love in it. You just have to build up that energy of love and compassion and kindness with your no. So say no with a lot of love in it and a lot of love behind it. So it's time to assert your boundaries. Maybe you haven't in the past, and now it's time. Now you're at that point in your spiritual path and your own growth and development where asserting your boundaries is completely appropriate. The world's waiting for you to show up as your most authentic self. That's what saying yes when you mean it and no when you mean it does. It shows the world that you know who you really are as a spiritual being, having this very human but spiritual experience, and you're willing to speak up, to speak from your soul, to assert your boundaries, to say yes when it's appropriate, no when it's appropriate, to take care of yourself and start saying yes to yourself more often. Yes to the things that you want to do. Yes to the life that you want to create, rather than saying yes to everyone else. So I trust and know that this supports you on your spiritual path. If it has, you can continue to come every week and join us for our Growing Edge Live Sunday broadcast. And you can financially support this message for healing hearts, transforming lives, and inspiring conscious evolution by financially supporting us and this ministry as we travel around the globe virtually. You can go to Venmo at Satya Center, SatyaCenter, or go to our website, growingedgelive.com. So peace and blessings to you. I'd like to close with a little prayer, a little activation, owning our yes. And owning our no. So as we come into this place of knowing that there is only one power, one presence, one infinite organizing intelligence, that is who and what we are. We are part of this one life, this one power, and this one presence, always asserting our love and our kindness and our generosity of spirit. So as we activate our yes, our sacred yes and our sacred no today, I trust and know that we are lifted up, that our wings are sprouting and our wings are growing, our wings are out as we take off, as we take flight, knowing who we are in truth, what we are in truth, and how we serve in truth. We actually serve the world and we bring more light to the world as we say yes and no when it is appropriate in doing so. So I give thanks for this time, this prayer, this moment of truth, this activation of consciousness, this expansion of awareness, knowing that what goes on right here in this heart and in this sacred container affects everything and everyone in a very positive and uplifting way. So peace and blessings, lots of gratitude to you. Have a great day. Mwah. Namaste. Bye-bye.